Where's the Smash, Ouija? Hey, why did Ouija quit Smash? Stop playing that shitty TF2 clone and get back to Smash, Ouija! Listen, I hear ya, okay? People only give a shit about me because of Smash. That is painfully obvious, right? So don't you worry your pretty little heads off, dear viewers. I'm not going to stop making Smash videos. I feel like I could stand on a mountaintop and shout that out to the world until I'm blue in the fucking face, and people would still think that every time I upload a non-Smash 4 video, it means that I'm quitting. So I thought, I don't know, I might as well try to clarify things here. Now you're probably asking yourself, how the fuck is he going to tie this train wreck of an intro into anything Ike-related? And the answer is, like this. So as is the case with most characters in this incredibly high skill level game, all you really need to do to win is spam one move for the entire match. And in Ike's case, that move is his side B, the dash and slash. This is a fantastic move that you should be using constantly. There are literally no downsides whatsoever to exclusively using it and nothing else throughout the entire fight. Some of you no doubt think that I'm completely full of shit because any player with half a brain could easily counter this, but listen. I've got a YouTube channel with over 64,000 subscribers. I think I know what I'm talking about. Just witness this poor Ganondorf get tossed around like he is a goddamn salad. If this doesn't convince you that the dash and slash is one of the greatest techniques in the game, I just don't know what will. Fair warning though, prolonged use of this may or may not result in your opponent reaching maximum salt capacity, causing him to SD and end the game as quickly as possible. Results may vary. As we all know, Smash 4 is mostly comprised of a bunch of Chinese cartoon characters, but Ike is the strongest of the Chinese cartoon characters, ruling over all of the others. So with that being said, don't you dare go tarnish his good name by losing to fucking Girl Marth. I mean, so far so good for this fight. I'm already a stock ahead, I got that rage building up. I think this should all be over in just a few more... Sorry, can we get a replay on that real quick? FUCKING WHAT?! Alright, bitch, that's enough. I'm gonna break you harder than Sakurai broke your hitboxes. In the words of our Lord and Savior, Steve Wilkos, get off my stage! I don't care if we are from the same franchise. There is absolutely no way in hell I'm going to lose to Hatsune Miku's long-lost brother over here. Playing male Robin. Man, you just gotta be a special kind of messed up to do something as stupid as that. I mean, like, for real, come on now. This guy looks like he really, really enjoys the color blue, so let's go ahead and end this with a giant blue explosion. I mean, I think that's only fitting, really. Now, I know this might blow your fucking mind, but Ike actually has the unique ability to counter incoming attacks with his down B, an incredible move which I really wish more characters had. In 4 Glory, spamming your counter is a perfectly viable strategy, but against a 4 Glory Little Mac, spamming your counter is by far the most viable strategy. More oftentimes than not, he'll be too afraid to even attack you, instead opting for grabs. But even against a completely motionless target, the 4 Glory Little Mac player still finds a way to fuck that up. Go ahead and let him get a few good hits on you, just to boost his confidence and lure him into a more false sense of security. And then when the time comes, completely destroy him. Okay, now, as fun as this meme is, I got other people I gotta go stomp on, so let's just go ahead and speed this up a little bit by doing more than just pressing down B. And there you go. There's that Little Mac recovery that we all know and love. Golly, this DDD sure looks like he's struggling. Maybe he would be better at video games if he had some more epic gamer gear, like say, oh, I don't know, maybe the all-new Ouija the God mousepad, oh shit! Featuring high-quality speed gaming surface, anti-slip rubber base, consistent tracking, and a durable cloth top! Links in the description. Please, please buy one! I'm begging on my knees right now! I apologize for that, I didn't have a choice.
So what have we learned?
Ike is pretty cool. Even though he isn't even close to being top tier in the actual game, he's definitely top tier in For Glory. His strength allows him to kill people super early, his counter's really easy to get off, and again, I'm not even memeing, the dash and slash technique is truly unstoppable. Also, I gotta say, it's really nice that they decided to give one of their strongest characters some bulk in this game, so that he doesn't look like a stupid fucking twig anymore. Anyway though, that's all from me, so... Man, I don't know. Outros are hard. Just do the thing. Thanks for watching.